गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम ए लेक्चर ऑन डायमेंशन एनालिसिस पार्ट टू। सो इन द प्रीवियस पार्ट ऑफ डायमेंशन एनालिसिस वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ डायमेंशन एनालिसिस, द मीनिंग ऑफ डायमेंशन एनालिसिस, देन मेथड्स ऑफ डायमेंशन एनालिसिस, देन फंडामेंटल एंड डिराइव्ड डायमेंशंस ऑफ सम क्वांटिटीज दैट वी आर फ्रीक्वेंटली यूजिंग इन फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स सब्जेक्ट। And then afterwards, out of two methods of dimension analysis, one Rayleigh's method we have covered in the dimension analysis part 1. Now in the dimension analysis 2, we are going to see the important method of dimension analysis, which is many times is used in the research, that is called as Buckingham's pi theorem method. Now in the Rayleigh's method, the drawback is there that if number of variables, dependent variables, are become more than 3 or 4, then that method become cumbersome, or the calculations involved in that method are become rigorous, and that is very difficult to solve the equations. Therefore, here when number of variables are more than 3 or 4, then Rayleigh's method is not suitable, and hence we have to switch towards the Buckingham's method. It is called as Buckingham's pi theorem. So this Buckingham's pi theorem is the method. Already I told that Rayleigh's method, analysis become laborious if the variables are become more than 3 or 4. Then what is this Buckingham's theorem is there? That if there are n number of variables involved in a physical phenomena, if physical phenomena involves n number of variables and that physical phenomena contain m number of fundamental dimensions. So if you consider all the properties involved in that physical phenomena variable, and if m number, these properties can be expressed by m number of fundamental dimensions, then that physical phenomena can be arranged, or that here that physical phenomena contains n minus m number of dimensional less terms, and that each dimensional less term is called as pi term. Okay, so I'll repeat again. If any physical phenomena contains n number of physical variables and can be represented by m number of fundamental dimensions, then it can be rearranged in n minus m dimensional less group, and each dimensional less group is called as pi term. It is called as Buckingham's pi theorem. So here also we have to write the fundamental dimensions of each and every variable, and we have to count what is m, okay, in that for describing that physical phenomena fundamental dimensions, and n number of variables we know, n minus m will be dimensional less groups. It is called as pi theorem. Now let us consider some mathematics behind the Buckingham's pi theorem. That is, let x1, that any physical phenomena contains x1, x2, x3 up to xn variables, and in that x1 is a dependent variable and remaining from x2 to xn are the independent variables. Then x1 repeating that dependent variable can be expressed as in terms of x2, x3 to xn as x1 is a function of x2, x3, x4 --, up to xn. And then equation 12.1 can be written as, what we can say here also, this can be written as another form, f1 of here x1 x2 x3 is equal to 0, or in terms of pi groups it can be also written as f1 of pi1 pi2 pi3 to pi^(n-m) is equal to 0. So each pi term is a dimensionless and independent of the system. Now for the pi term, if we can go for the operation like division, multiplication, it does not change that particular character of that particular pi term, and each pi term contains m plus 1 fundamental dimensions plus 1 variable. And here if a physical phenomena involves m is equal to 3, for defining all the variables we require all three fundamental dimensions, then m is equal to 3, and for that physical phenomena dimensionless group will be in each pi term will contain m plus 1, that is 3+1, 4 variables in the term. Now in that case we can write as a pi 1 can be written as here pi 1 is equal to x2 raised to a1 into x3 raised to b1, x4 raised to c1 and x4, where x4 is acts as a non-repeating variable and x2, x3, x4 are act as a repeating variable. Repeating means these variables repeat in each pi term. For example, this x2, if you go for another pi 2 term, it again contains x2, x3, x4, but its powers are different. In pi 1 term, its power is a1, then it's in x2 power, in pi 2 term will be a2, x3's pi term power in pi 2 term is b2, while in pi 1 term it is b1. Like that, pi 1, pi 2, pi n minus 1, n minus m, last term will be x2 raised to again a n minus m, x3 raised to b n minus m, and like that we can go for. So x2, x3, x4 are considered as repeating. Repeating means these variables are repeated, appears in each pi term, while this x1, x5, these terms will not repeat. These are called as non-repeating variable. So another way we can say that each pi term contains one repeating variables and one non-repeating variable. So non-repeating variable means what? It will not repeat in another pi term. So if x1 is repeating in pi 1 term, then it will not repeat in pi 2 term or pi 3 term. And x5 is repeating in here x pi 2 term, then it will not repeat in other pi term. So these are called as non-repeating variables, and repeating variables are there. These will be, how many are there? These will be m. Number of repeating variables is equal to number of fundamental dimensions, and m is equal to repeating variable, and each pi term contains repeating variables plus one non-repeating variable. Now then it is repeating, non-repeating variables will be no problem, but how to select repeating variables, because these variables repeats or appears in each pi term. So there is some guidelines or procedure is there to select the repeating variable. Then how many number of repeating variables should be there? It is given by that number of repeating variables is equal to number of fundamental dimensions of the problem or that phenomena. Now as per as possible, so dependent variable should not be selected as a repeating variable. So one, what is the priority there? First, dependent variable. So if x1 depends on so many phenomena properties, then x1 should not be selected as a repeating variable. Then the repeating variable should contain one, if there are three repeating variables, then one repeating variable should be from your length group, from geometric group. What is geometric group? Geometric means length, diameter, area, these are height, then depth. So this is going to be geometric parameter. So if any physical phenomena involves any kind of geometric property, then out of that one property we have to select as a repeating variable. Then another repeating variable should be from kinematic group. Kinematic means velocity group. That is, for example, velocity, acceleration, angular velocity, etc. For example, velocity, acceleration, etc. And third repeating variable always should be selected from flow property group, flow group. Then for this flow property, that is viscosity, density, viscosity. Then afterwards, we can call it as a bulk modulus of elasticity. So one from mu, rho, etc. So like that, property group one select, we have to select. So dependent variable should not be selected as a repeating variable. And another thing is there that if three repeating variables we have to select, then one should be selected from geometric group, one should be selected from kinematic group, and one should be selected from flow property group. Then no two repeating variables should have same dimensions. That we have to take care. So it means if L we are selecting, then another diameter we should not select. So it will be no two repeating variables should be have same dimensions. And repeating variables selected should not form a dimensional less group. So these are the properties. So first, and so most of the cases, if you see the properties, what will be the combination of the selecting of the repeating variable. So it is a diameter, velocity, density, or length, velocity, density, or length, velocity, viscosity, or diameter, velocity, viscosity. That way combination we can go for. Now we'll see how to solve the problems on Weyburg-King's theorem by considering one example. So we'll select this particular example, that is the resistance force R of a supersonic plane during a flight can be considered as dependent upon the length of aircraft L, velocity V, air viscosity mu, air density rho, and bulk modulus of elasticity K. Express the functional relation between these variables and resisting force. This is going to be example. Now here, what is there that repeating the resistance force depends on? What depends on? This resistance force depends on here length, velocity, viscosity, then density and K. Then that is R. R is a resistance. Then number of variables in the physical phenomena we have to count. What are number? How many number of physical properties? So R is their variable. R1, L2, V3, mu 4, rho 5, and K 6. So number of variables are 6. So N is equal to 6. So therefore, we can say that R is F of L, because R is a dependent variable. So this dependent variable should not be selected as a repeating variable. Afterwards, we'll see. So R is a F of what? L, V, mu, rho, K. Now here, we have to write the dimension, fundamental dimensions of each term. So for example, R, resistance. So resistance means what? Here it is going to be MLT. So means MLT raised to minus 2. Resistance means its force. It is Newton. Kg meter per second square. So kg means m, meter means l, and second square divided by, so it is t raised to minus 2. So m l t raised to minus 2. And therefore, here as one of the parameter required to express the physical phenomena, fundamental dimensions are 3 only. For R, we have to require, if any variable requires 3 fundamental dimensions, then m we have to take as a 3. And in that case, n is equal to 6, m is equal to 3. Then how many dimensionless groups will be there? It will be n minus m, and therefore it will become n minus m, and it will become here 6 minus 3, and this will become here 3. Then how many dimensionless groups will be there in that phenomena? F 3. We'll name that as a pi 1, pi 2, and pi 3. Okay. Then here f of pi 1, then we can say that f of pi 1 comma pi 2 comma pi 3 is equal to 0. Now each pi term will contain m plus 1 variable. So every pi term will consisting of 4 variables. Out of that, m means 3 are repeating variables and 1 will be non-repeating variable. Now each pi term contains how many variables? 4, and then it will be 3 pi repeating variables and 1 will be non-repeating variable. Now out of this 6 variable, we have to select which are the 3 repeating variables. Now, which are the 3 repeating variable? So, out of 6, R, we have to follow the procedure of selecting repeating variable. So, what is the first procedure is there that R, repeating variable, R, dependent variable, R should not be selected as a repeating variable. So, R will not be selected as a repeating variable. Then, one repeating variable should be from geometric group. So, which is the geometric group representing? So, L. The length will be one of the repeating variables. So let us consider L as a repeating variable. Then velocity group V, let us consider V is velocity as a repeating variable. And any property repeating variable we have to select, that is out of mu, rho, k, we will select depending on rho. First, basic properties, density. So we will give preference to density. So let us consider that from geometric group L, velocity group V, and from rho property group rho will be selected as a repeating variable. So each pi term contains this L, V, rho as repeating variables, but their power in each pi term is different, and each pi term will contain different non-repeating variable. Now repeating variables will be considered as non-repeating variable. For example, now if you consider L, V, rho as repeating, then R, dependent variable R, will be one of the in one pi term as a non-repeating variable. Then mu will be one of the non-repeating variable and k will be non-repeating variable. So here we can say that here then we have to form the pi terms. So pi terms contain three variables repeating and one non-repeating. There are three pi terms. So three pi terms means three non-repeating variable and three repeating variable. Now for first pi one term we'll form it as a L repeating means L V rho. So L pi 1 is there, pi 1 is L V rho into R, that is R, the first pi term, but here pi second pi term L V rho, again it is repeating, second pi 3 term L V rho, and non-repeating will be there, in first pi 1 term we will put as R as a non-repeating, second pi 2 mu as a non-repeating, and third pi 3 term K as a non-repeating. So this R mu and K not repeating only one, there appears in only one pi term, not repeating in other pi terms. But L, V, rho are repeating in all pi terms. But their power is different in each pi term. So for example, pi 1, L raised to A1, V raised to B1, rho raised to C1 into R. Then pi 2 term, L raised to A2, V raised to B2 and rho raised to C2. Now here our next aim is to represent pi term. We have to calculate what? We have to, the pi term is a dimensionless group. Means what? It is having no dimension. So m raised to 0, l raised to 0. And then to select the powers a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, l, a2, b2, c, a3, b3, c3. What we have to do is there that here we have to use the dimensions. Now pi 1 is a dimensionless group. Therefore it is m raised to 0, l raised to 0. T raised to 0 is equal to L raised to length dimension L raised to A1 via velocity L raised to L into T raised to minus 1 raised to B1 into rho M into L raised to minus 3 raised to C1 and R dimension ML T raised to minus 2. So here you have to remember that all variables we have to represent in terms of fundamental dimensions. Then we have to calculate this A1, B1, C1 by equating powers of m. If you equate the powers of m, what will be there? 0. Power LHS side, m is equal to 0. It is, here this side is equal to minus 3. Here it will be L. M we are going for. Then it will be m C1 only. So 0 is equal to C1 plus 1m. This will be. So therefore C1 is equal to minus 1. Equating powers of L. L raised to, LHS side, L raised to 0. 0 is equal to A1 plus here B1 plus minus 3 C1 plus 1. Okay. But we know the C1 value. Therefore, equation we are getting as a that A1 is equal to minus B1 plus 3 C1 minus 1. And B is equal to 2. So, B1. Now, calculate B1. Powers of T, if you equate, then T is equal to 0 is equal to minus B1 minus 2. And in that case, it will be B1 is equal to minus 2. If you put B1 is equal to minus 2, A1 will also become minus 2. So, what will be equation now we are getting? Pi 1 term is equal to, pi 1 is equal to L raised to A1. So, L raised to A1 means L raised to here minus 2, L raised to minus 2 we have got. Then L V raised to again minus 2 because B2 is, B1 is minus 2. Rho raised, C1 is minus 1, rho raised to minus 1 into R. And that we can rearrange. I, pi 1 is equal to R divided by L square V square rho. Rearranging, pi, R is pi 1 is equal to R upon rho L square V square. But similarly, we have to go for second pi term. So what is second pi term? It is pi 2 is equal to L raised to A2, V raised to B2, rho raised to C2 into mu. Again, here also, pi 2 is dimensionless group. Its dimension will be m raised to 0, l raised to 0, t raised to 0 is equal to l raised to a2. That way we have to write. And in that case, if you equate powers of m again, then we'll get c2 is equal to minus 1. If we go for powers of l, 0 is equal to like a2 plus b2 minus 3c2 minus 1. Then we are getting that a2 equation. And then powers of t, if you equate, then we'll get B2 is equal to minus 1. If you put B2 and C2 in equation number 2, then we'll get value of A2 is equal to minus 1. Then pi 2 term will become what? Here L raised to minus 1, V raised to minus 1, rho raised to minus 1 into mu. Here V is equal to mu into rho V L or L V rho. Then third pi term again, we have to go for third pi term. So again third pi term, here we have to pi 3 is equal to L raised to A1, B, V raised to D, B3, L raised to A3, V raised to B3, rho raised to C3 into K. K is a bulk modulus. So its dimension we should know. It is a M raised to 1, L raised to minus 2, T raised to 2. Okay. Then here it will be again powers of M we can go for. Powers of L we have to equate. Powers of T we have to equate. And then we will get that here pi 3 is equal to then in that case we are getting value of C1 is equal to minus 1, A3 is equal to 0 and B3 is equal to minus 2. Therefore pi 3 term we can go it as a L raised to 0, V raised to 2, rho raised to minus 1 into K or K divided by V square upon rho. Now if you get this all pi terms, then according to the Buckingham's pi theorem, F1 of pi 1 comma pi 2 comma pi 3 is equal to 0 or pi 1 is equal to phi of pi 2 comma pi 3. So pi 1 is equal to r upon rho l square v square, therefore is equal to phi into mu upon l v rho comma k v square rho. So k, this is pi 2, this is pi 3, already we got from the dimensional calculations. Then for r, this is a pi term, we can go for mathematical operation like our simple mathematics. Therefore r is equal to rho l square v square phi into bracket mu upon L V rho in comma K upon V square rho. This means R we have expressed in terms of these terms. Okay. So this way we have to use the Buckingham's pi theorem to express the relationship of one variable with the other variable or to form the groups. And so that if you perform the experiment on that group, and this group is called a dimensionless group. Here in this case, what is that? Mu upon rho V L is nothing but what? Our Reynolds number. So this way we have to go for this dimension analysis. Now say one example, I will quickly go through review this example. That is nothing but Buckingham's pi theorem, state Buckingham's pi theorem that we know. Then efficiency of fan n eta depends on density, dynamic viscosity mu and angular velocity and diameter. Then discharge, express eta in terms of dimensional parameters. So here also what we can go for, number of variables we have to calculate. How many number of variables are there? Eta is a function of rho here mu omega d and q. And how many number of variables are there? Eta itself is one. Eta rho 2, mu 3, omega 4, diameter 5 and q 6. So number of variables are 6. And for representing this, how many fundamental dimensions are required? MLT. So we know that dimensionals of rho is ML. So M here 2, here M is there. But mu, M raised to 1, L raised to minus 1, T raised to minus 1. So M. So to represent all this particular variable, we require L is M is equal to 3. Fundamental dimensions involved is equal to 3. Therefore, number of pi terms will become N minus M is equal to 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. Then each pi term will be contains what? Pi terms will be 3 and each pi term will contains 3 repeating variables because M is equal to 3 repeating variable and total number of variables will be 4. M plus 1 is equal to 4. Out of that, 3 are repeating and 1 is non-repeating. Now, here what we have to go for? Selecting repeating variables. Now, which variable we have to select repeating? Let us consider dependent eta should not be selected as a eta efficiency should not be selected as a repeating variable. Then out of 5, 3 variables we have to select as a repeating variable. So one should be selected from geometry group, that is diameter. Another will be there, that velocity group, omega. And another will be, last will be flow property, that is density. So pi 1 is equal to d, or here d omega rho are repeating and eta will be non-repeating. Second pi term, here mu will be non-repeating and third pi term, q will be non-repeating. So like way we can go for pi 1 term as a d raised to a1, omega raised to b1, rho raised to c1 into eta. Then like that pi 2 d raised to a2 omega raised to b2 rho raised to c2 into mu. Like pi 3 is equal to d raised to a3 rho omega raised to b3 rho raised to c3 into q. Then first pi term will be, we know that, and that we have to calculate now, a1 b1 c1, a2 b2 c2 and a3 b3 c3, like our previous numerical. Then we know that pi 1 term is dimensionless group. It is m raised to 0, l raised to 0, t raised to 0 is equal to what? Diameter L will be, it will be L raised to A1 omega T raised to minus 1, because it is radian per second, T raised to minus 1 raised to B1. Then density kg per meter cube, M raised to 1, L raised to minus 3 raised to C1 into eta. Eta is again a constant, no dimension, M raised to 0, L raised to 0, T raised to 0. Like that we can say that, then equating powers of M, LHS at M is equal to 0, therefore 0 is equal to C1 plus 0, C1 is equal to 0, powers of L, 0, A1 is equal to 0, powers of T, 0 is equal to minus B1, so B1 is equal to 0. So all terms will become what? A1, B1, C1 will become 0, therefore pi 1 term will become what? D raised to 0, then omega raised to 0, rho raised to 0, into eta, therefore pi 1 is nothing but what? Simply enter, eta, okay? Therefore, pi 1 is equal to only eta. Then, pi 2 term will be equal to again, d2 raised to a2, omega raised to b2, rho raised to c2 into mu. Then, mu dimensions of rho d already covered in pi 1 term. So, viscosity dimension, Newton second per meter square. If you write in the here simplified manner, it will become m raised to 1, l raised to minus 1, t raised to minus 1. Again, this we can write pi 2 dimensions m raised to 0, l raised to 0, t raised to 0 is equal to l raised to a2, t raised to minus 1 b2, m, okay. Like this, again, we can calculate again, powers of m is equal, we can equal in power 0 is equal to c2 plus 1, therefore c2 is equal to minus 1, 0 is equal to a2 minus 3, c2 minus 1, so here a2 will become minus 2, again, here b2 is coming as what? Minus 1. Like way, we can calculate A2, we have calculated A2 is equal to minus 2, C2 is equal to minus 1, B2 is equal to 3. Therefore, pi 2 will become D raised to A2 means D raised to minus 2, omega raised to B2, B2 means minus 1, rho raised to C2 means minus 1, therefore into mu, therefore is equal to mu upon D square omega rho, okay. Then similarly, pi 3 term, we know that pi 3 is equal to d raised to a3, omega raised to b3. These are repeating means always repeats in all pi term. D raised to a3, b, omega raised to b3, rho raised to c3 into q. Therefore, q dimension is nothing but discharge. Meter cube per second means what? L raised to 3 into t raised to minus 1. Then substituting values again, pi 1, pi 3 means m raised to 0, l raised to 0, t raised to 0 is equal to l raised to a3. Then we can, like this, we can form like our previous pi term. Then we have to equate powers of m here. If powers of m is equal to 0, is equal to c3, then we can get c3 is equal to 0. Powers of l is equal to, equating 0 is equal to a3 minus 3, c3 plus 3. Therefore, a3 is equal to minus 3. Then t, 0 is equal to minus b3. Okay, then b3 is equal to minus 1. That way, we have to, only simplification is there, that equations we have to write and we have to calculate the powers of m, equate the powers of m, l, t, and there will get the values of a3, b3, c3. Then a3 we got, c3, b3 we got, c3 we got. Then pi 3 is equal to d raised to minus, d raised to a3 means d raised to minus 3, omega raised to minus b3 means minus 1, rho raised to c3 means 0 and into q. Therefore, 0 raised to, rho raised to 0 is 1, therefore is equal to q upon t raised to d cube divided by rho, and then pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 we got. Then we know that f of pi 1, comma pi 1, comma pi 2, comma pi 3 is equal to 0, or pi 1 is equal to phi of pi 2, comma pi 3. Therefore, pi 1 is equal to simply eta, eta is equal to phi of here mu upon d square rho, d square omega rho, comma q d divided by d square omega. So these pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 are the dimensionless group, and we express this relation, okay. Like this, we have to solve the numericals on this particular Buckingham's pi theorem. So here very important thing is there, that we have to select number of variables, number of pi terms first, n minus m. Then we have to write each variable in a MLT form, fundamental form. We have to how many m number of variables, fundamental dimensions required to express phenomena, that we have to calculate from that. Generally, it may be 3 or 2, okay. Then we have to select the repeating variables. Each pattern contains m plus n variable, m plus 1 variable. Out of that, m are repeating variables. How many m is equal to that will be repeating variable, and one will be non-repeating variable. And then afterwards, we have to go for the repeating variable selection. In that case, no dependent variable should not be selected as a repeating variable. Then no repeating variable should have same dimensions. And one repeating variable from geometry group, one repeating variable from velocity group, and one repeating variable from flow property. And then afterwards, we have to write each pi terms, and by fundamental dimensions, we have to equate powers of m for each and every pi term, l and t. We'll get equations, we'll get values of A1, of three solving equation, A, B, C values of that respect to pi term, and we have to write the pi terms. And afterwards, pi f1 of pi 1 comma pi 2 comma pi 3 is equal to 0, or pi 1 is equal to another pi function of pi 2 comma pi 3, and we have to write the expression. So these are the Buckingham's Python. Now we have covered the dimension analysis part 1, so we have covered almost section 2 by this video. Thank you very much.